Good morning. Oh, hello. Good morning. I'm glad to see you all made it safely in the snow. I love snow. You can hate me now, but I love snow. I do want to build a snowman. So, I love snow. I hope you love snow. Just kidding. That doesn't matter. It's irrelevant. Good morning. All right. So, first off this morning. Oh, and good morning if you're watching online. Totally scatterbrained. Yes, I am. Okay. So, good morning. Now, we are going to start out the morning with a video. It is Sanctity of Life Sunday. And our very own Pregnancy Choices here in town has just a short video. We'll watch it, and then we're going to talk about it a little bit.
Created for purpose, a unique genetic blueprint from the moment of conception. DNA woven together to determine gender, eye color, hair color, fearfully and wonderfully made. Valued beyond measure. Our culture says life is disposable. Her rights matter most. It's not really a baby. And it's all one big choice. But God created us in His own image and whispered, "I have called you by name. You are mine." In the United States, abortion is legal throughout the entire pregnancy, totally unrestricted. Most recently, abortion has been boxed up in the form of two little pills and a promise to make it all go away. What will you do to make a difference for life? How can you be a voice? Will you help save a life? There are over 2,700 pregnancy centers in the United States, serving men and women free of charge and full of hope, providing pregnancy tests, life-affirming counsel, abortion recovery, classes, clothing, and diapers. Many centers offer the first glimpse of a woman's baby in the womb, displaying the magnificence of creation and the precious beats of a tiny heart, perfectly formed and fashioned by the one who created them. They serve faithfully, love well, encourage. They are hope dealers. They need volunteers, your prayers, and your financial support. Will you please give generously and help make a difference for life today?
So, Pregnancy Choices does so much in this town. Corey, he teaches abstinence classes, or I Decide for Me classes, in the local schools in the area. Goes in and tells them that they're worth something, and to wait until marriage. And so, there's so many aspects that Pregnancy Choices does. Now, coming in the coming months, we are actually going to have a local missions emphasis. And one of those weeks is going to be for Pregnancy Choices. I've been talking to Rebecca Smith just about different ways that we can help, you know, by giving, by serving, by being a mentor, you know, there's so many different ways, by volunteering. And so after this video, the life is so precious. It really is. And I would just like every one of us, whether we're here or watching online, to be praying. For God to start stirring in our hearts. Like, what is it that He may be asking us to do? To help out in our backyard, our mission field. You know, Pregnancy Choices might be it. We're also going to talk about Hickory next door. Just different local missions. And we're going to get really into it. And also with that, the sanctity of life. You know, it's so important for us to support Pregnancy Choices. And it's also so important for us to support Pregnancy Choices by supporting life after birth. You know, we have to be the local church and the body that comes alongside and is there for moms and dads. We got to support the family all the way up. And so that is something else I want us to be praying about. Just how, what is it? Maybe God has put something on your heart, because we're here to support it for the long haul. We support pregnancy choices to make the decision for life or adoption or any of these things. But then it's up to us to come alongside them and say, hey, we're here. We are here for when you got the terrible twos or when you're down and out. We got you all the way up. So that is just so important for us to be praying about. So yes, more on pregnancy choices is coming. Baby bottles are going to be coming back. I'm super excited, but definitely be praying with me up until then, just about what we can do together and as individuals. And then also coming up this week is Junior Bible Quiz. So ages 4 to 5th grade, JBQ is coming back on Wednesday nights. Super excited, because what better way than getting scripture into the next generation, right? Super awesome. And then also our teenagers, oh yeah, they are continuing in their Avengers series, which is really awesome. I know Megan spoke last week about Captain America. Neely's coming up in the next few weeks. We got, like, Corey's got the whole, got them all in there, digging into God's word and just taking, oh, it's awesome. You know what? If you want to come and you want to sit in on that, you got to ask Corey, but I recommend you do it. And then our children, JBQ, come on, we got all kinds of stuff going on in this building. And then we're still diving into the armor of God. Last week was fun. I enjoyed it. I hope you guys did too. And then this week we had a special teacher, Emily Pletch. So is going to be teaching about peace. Yes, so you don't want to miss it. That's Wednesday nights at 6:30. And now we have a Nathan Brown, the Nathan Brown, coming to speak to you.
So I think everybody probably knows me, Nathan Brown. I serve as the secretary on the board, and I've just wanted to make an announcement today from the board. We have ask a individual to candidate for lead pastor position, and that is going to happen on February 13th. So we'll be announcing that the next few Sundays. So February 13th, we've asked Debbie Lopez to come and candidate as the lead pastor for Lenten Assembly of God, and that will be followed, that morning service after she preaches will be followed by probably a brief break after the service, after the morning AM service. And we'll come back with a question and answer time for her, and then that will be followed by a vote. So all members of Lenten Assembly of God are available to vote on that position, and that will be held directly after the morning service on February 13th. If you're unable to be here in that morning service, you can vote absentee ballot. We ask that you would get that in the mail, and the church needs to receive that by the 12th. By that Saturday, the 12th, to be able to count for that vote. So if anybody has any questions on that, they can ask me, ask a board member, and hopefully we can answer anything. Without further ado, we'll have the praise team come up for praise and worship this morning. Also, just a little encouragement as they're coming up, not just because a couple of my daughters are on here, but isn't it nice to see some of the younger kids interested in being a part of praise and worship and leading? Let's give them a hand. So again, as they're getting ready, we're going to take up offering this morning. That slipped my mind. Apologize. So Debbie Lopez is going to come around and collect the offering. Maybe Matt might help her. It'll be a nice tandem duo. So let's just pray over the offering. Father, we thank you for the provisions that you've given us. And Lord, as your word commands, we just give a portion of that back to you. in tithes and in offering, Lord. And may you be blessed. May you further this kingdom and this church. In your name we pray. Amen.
If you would please stand up for worship and come to the front, maybe, if you want to. I just encourage you to do something different today. Whether that's come stand up here, maybe step out in the aisle, or like come sit in the front, and just encourage you to do that while we worship.
Sure.
Darkness tries to roll over my bones, when sorrow comes to steal the joy I own, when brokenness and pain is all I know, I won't be shaken, and I won't be shaken. My feet doesn't stand a chance. Thank you.
Just want you. Jesus, you don't owe me anything more than anything that you can do. I just want you.
This is my worship, this is my offering, in every moment I withhold nothing, learning to trust you, even when I can't see it, even in suffering. To believe it. If you say it's wrong, then I'll say no. If you say release, I'm letting go. If you're in it with me, I'll begin. When you say to jump, I'm diving in. If you say be still, then I will wait. If you say to trust, I will obey. I don't want to follow my own way. Done chasing feelings. Spirit, lead me.
I'm like a burden, but once I could grasp it, you took me further than I was asking. Worth it all. My life is an altar that your fire falls. If you say it's wrong, then I'll say no. If you say release, I'm letting go. If you're in it with me, I'll begin. And if you say to jump, I'm diving. Still, then I will wait. And if you say to trust, I will obey. Teach me how to follow in your way. Done chasing feelings. Spirit, lead me.
Oh.
say release, I'm letting go. If you're in it with me, I'll begin. And when you say to jump, I'm diving in. If you say be still, then I will wait. If you say to trust, I will obey. You're the only truth, the life, the way. I'm done chasing feelings. Spirit, lead me. There's a grace when the heart is under fire. Another way when the walls are closing in. When I look at the space between where I used to be and this wreck in me, another in the fire standing next to me. There was another in the waters holding back the seas. Should I ever need reminding of how I've been set free? There's a cross that bears the burden. Another in the fire.
Joy come every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. Count the joy come every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. Count the joy come every battle, 'cause I know that's where you'll be. Between all the things unseen and this reckoning, I know I will never be alone. I know I will never be alone. Being another in the fire, standing next to me, will be another. See you. to me. Oh, count the joy come every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. Oh, count the joy come every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be. Oh, count the joy come every battle, cause I know that's where you'll be.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for being with us in every battle. Thank you, Lord, for being with us in everything that we're going to face that we don't even know yet. Lord, just thank you. Thank you for caring about us. Thank you for, just thank you, Lord, for everything. Lord, as we continue today, just continue to have your way in our hearts and our minds, whether we're here or watching online, Lord. Continue to have your way in every one of us. Open up our hearts and our minds for the word that you have for us today. Lord, just have your way completely in every one of your children today, Lord. Lord, we love you, and we ask this in your mighty name. Thank you, guys. I love that we are so fortunate to have amazing worship team members of every generation. I love it. I love that God's like, hey, here's different groups. Here, let's worship. Let's get it on. It's awesome. I love it. I love it so much. So last week, we talked about salvation and sin and the fact that we got to realize that we all need a Savior. So before we get to this week's topic, so the last 3 or 4 months, services, conversations with people, God's been getting us ready. Words that he's given, things, God is getting us ready. The messages have been about self-evaluation, unity, building on the foundation we have, being called to share the gospel in and through our lives, the call that each of us have to spend time with him, so that we can do out of spending time with him. He's been getting us ready. Now, it's like we're leading up to takeoff. Picture this with me. It's like we're getting ready for a trip. We're packing. We're getting the house ready to go. So while we're gone, you know, you're getting everything taken care of. And so once you get the house ready to go and your bags are packed, you know, you head to the airport. And then you go through airport baggage claim and then security. And then you find your terminal and you wait for your airplane to be ready. You see people getting off and you're waiting. Then waiting at the gate, a little anxiousness kicks in. Even if you've never flown, a little anxiousness kicks in, whether it be excitement or a little nervousness, because we gotta trust the pilot. We don't know him, but we're gonna trust him. Then it's time to board the plane. We get on, we buckle up, we take off. And that takeoff is a rush with a lot of prayer. At least with me, it's a lot of prayer. Like, Lord, please don't let this crash. please don't let this crash. There's other ways that I'd like to go. Please not let it be this. So right now, in all this preparation that God has been doing in us and through us these last 3 or 4 months, we've arrived at the airport. We are at the airport right now. And it's time for us to check our baggage and baggage claim and go through security. Now the question is, are we going to make it through security? Are we going to get told, nope, sorry, you don't have clearance? So all of that is to say, God's been prepping us. He's been getting us ready. And it's been a lot of the same theme the Holy Spirit's been working in. But it's because God wants us. He's getting ready to take off. He is our pilot. He is getting ready to take off. Something amazing is coming. It is. The harvest is coming. But He wants us to be ready. That's why He's been saying self-evaluate, unity. We got to read His word. We got to spend time with Him. Last week, we got to recognize the sin in our lives and ask for forgiveness because we need a Savior. And then we have to be able to share the gospel. He's getting us ready, and I don't know what's coming, but we can all feel it. There's a little bit of tension, there's a little bit of excitement, there's a little bit of fear. But man, it's coming. But we got to be ready. So with that, you know, we got to grow. We have to be growing. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. Now may the God of peace make you holy in every way, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless until our Lord Jesus Christ comes again. Jesus is coming back. We don't know when, we don't know the date or the time, but He's coming back, and we got to be ready. Now, part of that scripture says, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless until our Lord Jesus Christ comes back. So, last week we talked about this on Wednesday night. So, we're made of 3 parts. Our soul, our spirit, our soul, and our body. Now, when we asked Jesus, and I love the way this was explained last week, we listened to a little thing from Tony Evans, and he explained this in such a way that I was like, I like that. I'm going to use that, so I'm using that. All right, so we're spirit, soul, and body. Now, when we ask Jesus Christ into our lives as our Lord and Savior, our spirit is saved. It is. Our spirit is saved, and that is amazing. But our souls need refined. They need to continually grow. Sanctification is the process that comes after salvation. Salvation is instant when we ask Him into our lives and repent of our sins and He becomes our Lord and Savior. Now, sanctification is a lifelong process, but it's our souls that are being sanctified. It's our souls growing to be more and more like Christ. And our bodies, they act and do out of our souls. When our souls are being sanctified, when our souls are growing in the Lord and growing closer to the Lord, our physical bodies act out of that. And so, man, with all that in mind, the questions of the day are, what is growing in us? Where are we growing? And what are we growing in? Colossians 2:7. Let your roots grow down into Him, and let your lives be built on Him. Then your faith will grow strong in the truth you were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. That's pretty awesome. We are to let our roots grow into Jesus, and let our lives be built on Him. And then when we do that, our faith will grow. It'll grow strong in the truth that we know is Scripture and will overflow with thankfulness. I want that. I hope you want that too. Isaiah 40:30. Even youths will become weak and tired, and young men will fall in exhaustion. Are we falling in exhaustion? Are we growing weary? Are we living in a state of tired? Isaiah 40:31. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. So this next verse that we just read goes on to tell us that if we're growing in exhaustion, weariness, tiredness, that we must go and find trust in the Lord to find our new strength. Because there are so many things that we can grow in us that are unhealthy. It's exhaustion, weariness, workaholism, pride, biblical ideas rather than the Word of God, politics, our opinions. Yes, I said our opinions. Because if we're allowing our opinions to grow more than our knowledge of the Word of God, then how in the world are we going to fulfill the Great Commission if all we're sharing are our opinions and not God's Word so people can be saved? It's not going to happen. So we can't be more interested in being right in our opinions than we are in God's Word. And then we can also grow in sin. James 1:14-15. Temptation comes from our own desires, which entice us and drag us away. These desires give birth to sinful actions, and when sin is allowed to grow, it gives birth to death. Our desires from our souls, if our souls are not growing, will give birth to sinful actions. So when our souls, if we're not growing at all, and we are still growing in sin, if our souls are growing in sin, it will give birth to sinful actions. We'll give in to temptation. And then if these actions are not stopped, if we do not ask for repentance and invite Jesus in, it leads to spiritual death. We are all constantly growing, every one of us. Even if we aren't trying, we're growing in something. It's just like a child. They're constantly growing before our eyes. But we don't see the day-to-day growth. Emily and Elijah, there are some mornings they wake up and come in. And I'm like, whoa, when did you get so big? They're going to be 5 next week. I have no idea where that time went. But they've grown before my eyes. I've been there every step of the way. They grew so fast. And it's the same thing with things that grow in us. There are things that are growing in us right before our eyes. And before we know it, it's like, oh, I never intended for that to get out of hand. I never intended for that one choice to turn into an entire ball of hellfire. But man, it grows fast. So what we are growing in matters. What are we supposed to grow in? Back to Colossians 2:7. Let your roots grow down into him, and let your lives be built on him. Then your faith will grow strong in truth. You were taught, and you will overflow with thankfulness. And then Colossians 6:7 in the Message version. My counsel for you is simple and straightforward. Just go ahead with what you've been given. You receive Christ Jesus, the Master. Now live him. You're deeply rooted in him. You're well constructed upon him. You know your way around the faith. Now do what you've been taught. School's out. Quit studying the subject and start living it. And let your living spill over into thanksgiving. Quit studying the subject and start living it. It does not get any more cut and dry than that. It doesn't. We all have been given what we're supposed to do. We must pray. We must read his word. We got to spend time with other believers. Iron sharpens iron. That's why we're here on Sundays. This isn't meal time. This is iron sharpens iron time. This is the time where God gives us a word and we are accountable to each other to apply it to our lives. Meal time is when we are by ourselves, reading and praying on our own, that's mealtime. This is the time that we have to be together and worship together and grow together. We got to spend time with him, before we spend time doing things for him. As Pete Scazzaro says, I know the staff is so tired of me saying this. I already know it. Yeah, Corey's shaking his head, yes. I'm just kidding, he's not. Anyways, but our doing has to flow out of our being. We have to be with God so that we can do for God. Otherwise, all kinds of things start growing in us. Resentment, exhaustion, weariness. We get so tired of serving that the thought of someone asking us to help is just irate. I've been there. But so our being has to come first before our doing. It's so important. And also when we're spending time being in his presence, we get the direction. God says, hey, I need you to grow in this area a little bit more. Or God says, hey, you gotta cut this off. This is growing and it's not healthy. I know it's not sin, but man, this is not good for you. And so when we're spending time with him, he can address these things in us and we can take care of it. Now, as a church, we offer things in this building. We do. And it's awesome because we get to come together and learn together and dig into his word together. It's amazing. But it's up to us as individuals to do it. It's up to us to dig in to the word on our own. No one can pray salvation for you. I can't pray the prayer of salvation for someone I love. They gotta choose it. Just like they have to choose to live the way we've been asked to live. So even if it's not sin that's growing, we must ensure that the things in our lives that are growing and outshining Jesus in us must be acknowledged and taken care of. So if there are things in our lives that are growing, that are taking the place of Jesus, man, we can't wait for a Sunday morning altar call. We can't. You cannot. Jesus is coming back. We don't know if it's in 5 minutes from now, 5 years, 500 years. We have no idea. He's returning. It's the blessed hope. And we can't wait for a Sunday morning altar call to get right with the Lord. We got to do it in our own personal time. Whether we're listening to worship music in the car, or we're praying, or we're reading, we got to get right with him every day. We need to repent because we all sin. But the difference between someone who's not saved and someone who is saved is the fact that we can go to our Heavenly Father and say, Lord, please forgive me and help teach me the way to go. And if you're not saved, man, you got to stop. You got to live for Jesus, because trust me, if you try it, you won't be disappointed. It's not always a walk in the park, but man, it's good, because there is a hope that even when the times are rough, that there is a strength, like we read, that only comes from God, that get us through when we don't want to live anymore, when we don't want to face tomorrow, when we're sick of it, and we think that our lives will never turn around. Jesus is there, and he says, no, it will, because you have me. He is there for us when we're ready just to call it quits. He's there saying, no, don't. I love you. I have a plan. Hold on to me through this hard season. And he does. Like that last worship song this morning. There is another in the fire. It's Jesus. He walks through every fire with us, every good time with us, because he cares about us. So we're never alone. So we can't wait for that Sunday altar call. We can't, because there may not be one. God might be like, hey, no altar call today. I want my kids to learn to repent on their own. So we got to do it. We got to repent on our own. We got to keep an eye on ourselves with the Holy Spirit's help. The Spirit's not just in this building. He lives in every one of us. He's our advocate. He's here. I've seen the meme that says, man, somebody says, hey, why do you need the Holy Spirit to go to church? And they're like, man, I need the Holy Spirit to go to Walmart. Come on, that's real life right there. I need the Holy Spirit to even park at Walmart sometimes. He's with us. He is with us in every aspect of life. So we have to make sure we're stopping the things in us that need to be pruned, severed off, or burned to the ground. So that what needs to grow, so that what God wants to grow in us can. We can't allow what God wants us to grow to be smothered out by the things that we should have never picked up to start with. So what happens when we take the time to grow in the things that God has asked us? In our time being with Him, in our time reading His Word and praying and trusting Him and speaking truth in love. Ephesians 3:17. Then Christ will make His home in your hearts as you trust in Him. Your roots will grow down into God's love and keep you strong. Ephesians 4:15. Instead, we will speak the truth in love, growing in every way more and more like Christ, who is the head of His body, the church. That's what happens. Growing in every way more and more like Christ, who is the head of the body. That is sanctification for our souls. We're never done growing, ever. We're never done growing. There are always areas that we must improve in. Sanctification is a process. But having roots grown into God's love so that we may be strong when we face trials, man, that's the kind of strength that only comes from God. No other person, no other thing can give us that kind of strength except for God. And there's always room for improvement. It's not pleasant. It is not always easy. Most of the time it's uncomfortable, and the whole time it's like, all right, God, this pressure, I'm about to bust. And He's like, no, you're not. I know what I'm doing. We got to get this out of you. But it's worth it. It's worth it. And the awesome thing is, there's no timeline. Sanctification is a lifelong process. The key is that we're always growing. As long as we're taking the steps and we're doing it, school's out. It's time to stop studying it and live it. Now, that doesn't mean stop studying. There's a difference. We still have to read God's Word. But we also have to live it. We can't just study, 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 preparing to live. We got to live now while we can. Jesus is coming back, you guys. And when we're growing, there are times that the growth is fast. It is fast and it is painful. And there are times that it is fast and it was so fast that we didn't even feel the pain till it was done. And then there are times that we're growing slow and steady. It just depends on the season of life. But both are good. Because when we live our lives rooted in Christ, we can speak truth and share the gospel with confidence. So the last question of the day is, where is God asking you to grow stronger in right now? What is it that God is asking you to grow in? And you may not know. There may be things right now you might just be hurting and walking through the pressure, and all you can do is put one foot in front of the other. You're growing. Hold on to Him. And you may not know it. You may not know what He's doing right now. But don't give up. Because someday you'll look back and you'll say, oh, that's what He was doing. He used this situation to refine my soul. So there are times we don't know what He's growing in us. But there are times that He's saying, hey, come on. Read more. Pray more. All right, you got to stop doing this and spend time with me. Stop making excuses. Come on. And we're like, no. Those are things that he wants us to grow in, that we have to grow in. And so what is it that you might need to grow in right now? Is it being with him, reading his word, praying? Is it trusting him, speaking truth in love and not condemnation, giving control over to him? Because, man, when our lives are out of control and things are going on around us that we have no control over, for me, when that happens, I want to control everything down to the cleaning of my house. Matt will come home, and I'll have the entire house rearranged and cleaned, and he's like, okay. And I'm like, I can't control anything else going on right now, but I can control this. And so there are ways that it starts coming out in us, or if we want to drop everything and run. Man, that's us trying to take control over our lives when things around us are bigger than us going on. And so that's something that we have to learn to give him total control in. Whether it be our finances, our relationships, whatever it is, we got to give him control. And it is not easy. But man, once you do, it's like, oh, okay, I can breathe a little now. Is it believing that he has a purpose for you still? Are you wondering if you still have a purpose? If you're breathing, you have a purpose. It doesn't matter. Tallulah has a purpose. She's a baby. She has a purpose. Every one of you have a purpose. It doesn't matter how young or how old you are. You have a purpose. And we got to spend time with our Father in his presence, so we can fulfill that purpose. And maybe it's serving. Maybe he's asking you to serve somewhere and you're like, I don't know if I can. I don't know if I'm going to be good at it. Stop thinking about I, trust God and do it. So it's up to us to be willing to live it, to do it. Ephesians 4:15. Instead, we will speak the truth in love, growing in every way more and more like Christ, who is the head of his body, the church. Sanctification, growing to be more like Christ. Our souls growing to be more like Christ so that our bodies quit acting a fool. It's a process, but man, it's beautiful. It is beautiful what God will do in and through each of us. I want to leave us with this scripture today. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. Now may the God of peace make you holy in every way, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless until our Lord Jesus Christ comes again. So our iron sharpens iron challenge for the week is to grow, to say yes to God. Wherever he's pulling us right now, whatever he's trying to refine in us, even if we don't know what it is, but man, you feel that pressure. Just say yes to him and to live the way he has asked us to live. This week, we have to dig into his word. We have to pray. We have to be with him so that everything we do can flow out of him. And if you feel like you don't have a purpose, you do. I don't know why that's on my heart so heavy this morning, but you have a purpose. You do. Your purpose might be something that you consider insignificant, but to someone else, it means everything. It means everything. You have a purpose. God created you. He created me. And he has a plan for our lives, and that is awesome. But it takes some growing and refining and being uncomfortable to get there. So this week, Actually, right now, let's just take a minute. GJ and Matt, would you put on some music? Let's just take a moment right now and invite God in and say, God, whatever's, just point out things in me. God, begin a work in me. Point out things in me that I need to change. Things in me that aren't of you, so that I may grow in you. All right, let's pray. Dear Lord, right now, as we are still in your presence, Lord, together as a family, Lord, you come in right now and you just begin the process of the things that we need to get rid of, the unhealthy things that are digging root into our souls, Lord. You come in right now and you begin just to point those out in us so that we may turn them over to you, so that we may prune them, so that we can grow more and more in you, Lord. Lord, right now, just have your way completely in this place for these next few minutes. And let us just begin speaking to you, Lord.
Jesus, bring new wine out.
Lord, thank you. Thank you for continuing to use us for your glory. Thank you, Lord, for continuing to care about us and wanting us to grow more and more so that we can be more and more like you, Lord. Just thank you. Lord, as we leave here today, continue to just build the desire in us to just live for you. To stop saying tomorrow and to say, yes, today, I'm going to do it today. Lord, just continue to just build your word in our hearts. Continue to build that thirst for you and the things of you, Lord. Lord, have your way completely in each and every one of us. In our day-to-day lives, at work, wherever we are, at school, let you shine through us. Lord, we love you, and we trust you in this growing process. Lord, we love you, and we ask this in your name. Amen. Don't let that end here. Talk with God. You still got a purpose. I'm going to blame that on Garrett Bowersock, even though it was me. Anyways, you guys have a great week. Don't let that end here. You have a purpose. We still have a purpose. It's going to be an awesome Wednesday night. If you're able, we would love for you to come. If you're not able, if you're quarantined or you're not able to come and you want to zoom in, we are actually going to zoom in with two people this week. I didn't tell Emily this, but it'll just be voice Zoom. So if you're interested in that, come see me. We'll get you on that list, or call me or send me a text, and we'll make sure that you can be a part of it too. Also, teenagers and kids, hey, everybody needs to be here, whether you're 100 or 2 months old. I love you guys. We'll see you Wednesday.